क्लास 9 केमिस्ट्री।
हेलो, वेलकम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। होप यू ऑल हैव डन चैप्टर 2 थरोली एंड वॉच दिस चैप्टर ऑन यूट्यूब चैनल इंदिरा मिन्हास विच इज अपलोडेड अर्लियर। टुडे वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर 3 दैट इज वाटर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लुक एट द सिलेबस विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस चैप्टर। That water is a universal solvent. So many topics are mentioned here. One by one we'll take here. The syllabus is mentioned at the top of the chapter in the beginning. So one by one we'll take these topics. So let us begin. You know, water, the formula is H2O and it is also, the chemical name is dihydrogen oxide. The chemical name is dihydrogen oxide. And structure and all I will explain you later. And today just see the explanation of water. You know, water is most important natural resource. 70% of earth area is occupied with water. It exists in three physical states. First, solid, that is ice, liquid, that is water, gas, that is water vapor. Water occurs in both free and combined state. Water has ability to dissolve wide range of substances. So it is considered as universal solvent because many of the substances get dissolved in water. That is why it is known as the universal solvent. This is a major topic of this chapter, that water as a universal solvent. This topic will do it in the detail. And water is purified for drinking purpose. This is the most essential liquid which we use for drinking, and it is purified by removing suspended impurities. Water contains suspended impurities. This is removed by filtration, and dissolved impurities are removed by distillation. And bacterial impurities are removed by adding calculated amount of chlorine. And about the water cycle, from the previous classes you people are doing, and you know the water cycle, we have done it in the geography and general science also. From your lower classes you know about this water cycle, so here I will not explain. Page number 34. You know, water is a major constituent of all living things, that is plants, animal and human life. All, even the 70% of our body weight is water only. And physical properties of water, if you will see, you know the nature of water, that is pure water is clear, transparent. It is colorless, odorless and tasteless. Generally, the taste in water is due to gases and solid dissolved in it, that is impurities present in it. Generally the pure water is having no taste, it is tasteless, but the water which we usually drink, we found taste because of the presence of the impurities. And all of you know the boiling point under normal pressure. You did it in the previous class also. The water boils at 100 degree Celsius, and the boiling point of water is affected by pressure, because boiling point of liquid is considered as the temperature when vapor pressure equals the atmospheric pressure, and the greater the pressure, higher is the boiling point. Lower the pressure, lower is the boiling point. So by this principle only, this pressure cooker works. And you know, at hill station what happened, generally, you know, atmospheric pressure is being low there. So generally what happened, water boils at temperature lower than 100 degrees Celsius. You know, usually the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Being lower atmospheric pressure at hills, what happens, especially on the top of the Mount Everest, there the water boils below 100 degree, that is at 70 degree Celsius. So cooking of food is very difficult. Therefore, at high altitudes, we use pressure cooker. The boiling point of all water also increases due to the presence of dissolved impurities. To increase the boiling point, generally we add impurities. Here we consider, while cooking, we consider common salt, that is NaCl, as an impurity. When we add that impurity, then the boiling point of water increases. So this makes our cooking very easier on hill stations or in hilly areas. And the freezing point of water is, or melting point of ice is same, that is 0 degree Celsius under normal pressure. And freezing point of water decreases with increase in pressure. Now you can take an ice in your hand, just take out the ice from the fridge, and when you press it between the palms, see what happened. You can do this experiment. You hold the ice cube in your palm and press with the both the palms in between like a sandwich. See what happened. How quickly will it melt or it will not? So is there any effect of pressure on melting? You can observe it. You can perform this experiment. And the density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. The density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. And generally, this also you did it in the previous class. That is, it is 1000 kg per cubic meter or 1 gram per cubic centimeter. And at this temperature, that is at 4 degrees Celsius, density is maximum, but volume is minimum. Water expands on freezing. Water expands on freezing. It means 92 volume of water becomes 1000 volume of ice. Therefore, with relative density of ice being, that is 0.92, that's why it floats. So at 4 degrees Celsius, water saw a peculiar behavior, which is known as a anomalous expansion of water. Look at this graph. Here, in this graph, y-axis and x-axis, y-axis density is taken, and x-axis representing temperature in degree Celsius, and y-axis density in gram per milliliters. So you will draw this graph in your notebook. Do practice it. This is very important. It do come in the exam. Draw the graph to show water has maximum density at 4 degrees Celsius. So you see, the temperature is taken from minus 10 to 20 degrees Celsius. At 4 degrees Celsius, you see the density of water is maximum. At 4 degrees, this is minus 10, minus 5 like this. So at 4 degrees Celsius, the density of water is maximum, and this density is 1.000 is mentioned here, that is gram per milliliters. So this property of anomalous expansion of water is very useful. So that I will describe in the next video. Till then, you read this page 34, find out some more short questions, draw this graph, practice this graph, and watch the next video. Thank you.